NASA's planning to land astronauts on Mars by 2030s. Some of the biggest challenges are to make the Mars habitable for the astronauts and getting them home. Both of these challenges require oxygen. Launching a rocket off the surface of Red Planet will require industrial quantities of oxygen, which is a crucial part of propellant. Shipping all that oxygen from Earth isn't currently viable, so NASA came up with an idea to create oxygen from the Mars atmosphere, which has 96% carbon dioxide. They have created an experimental device called MOXIE. This device works like a tree. It pulls in carbon dioxide from atmosphere, then uses an electrochemical process to separate two oxygen atoms from each molecule of carbon dioxide. This electrochemical conversion requires a lot of heat, so it is designed with special heat-tolerant materials. MOXIE is the part of Perseverance rover, so to protect rover system from those blistering temperatures, outside of MOXIE is coated with a thin layer of gold. This experimental device is a little larger than a toaster, and it can make 6 to 10 grams of oxygen per hour, which is just enough for a small dog to breathe. The weight of actual full-scale system will be around 2200 pounds, and NASA is working to create a full-scale prototype in the near future. MOXIE is the part of Perseverance rover, which was launched on July 30, 2020 and now on its way to Mars, and expected to land on Mars on the 18th of February 2021. The main job of the Perseverance rover is to seek signs of ancient life and collect rock and soil samples. NASA team expects to run MOXIE about 10 times over the course of one Mars year, which is equal to 2 Earth years. It will allow them to watch how well it works in varying seasons and how a number of environmental factors, including dust storms, wind, sand, and temperature of the carbon dioxide, could affect MOXIE. Results will help to design the future oxygen generators. Recently, scientists at the Washington University in St. Louis have proposed a new way to make oxygen on Mars, which uses a completely different resource, salty water in the lakes beneath the Martian surface. The process electrolyzes the salty water and splits it into the hydrogen and oxygen. Most of the water known to exist on Mars is the ice, but scientists detected a salty lake under the Mars southern ice cap and a number of smaller salty ponds nearby. NASA's principal investigator for the MOXIE said that one day, electrolysis of water would be important for the fuel production on Mars, but not necessarily in the way outlined in this study. He said that extracting oxygen from the air is easy by comparison because it's everywhere. You don't have to go dig anything up, and that's why we are doing it first. You can track the live status of Perseverance rover at NASA's website, link in the description below. Would you like to go on Mars? Let us know in the comments. Hit the like button and subscribe our channel for more updates.